tracks! Reforjax! Everybody, we're back. Max Trax here again. Thank you all for watching that Facebook Live. Max Trax bringing you all the sick Max riffs of my career, of the whole fucking thing. All those years of riffing, Riff Lord Mania, Riff Vortex, especially for you. And I might add, for free. We don't want no money. We just want your love and support. Anyway, man, it's so sick to be here doing this for you guys. I fucking love it. Got a special song. It's a lot of people's favorite song because of the lyrics and because of the vibe. And I know it's Gloria. It's one of Gloria's favorite songs. It's No Hope Equals No Fear. Yes. No Hope, No Fear from Soulfly 1. I got a funny, cool story also from Soulfly 1, from the recording. So this is going to be fun, man. No Hope, No Fear. Tune to B. Straight from the original. No demo on this one. And so let's just get jamming. No Hope, No Fear. Tune to B. Are you motherfuckers ready? Headbangers, brothers and sisters of metal. The whole tribe out there, are you ready? Let's do this. No Hope, No Fear. Archangel. So yeah, it's just like, so go right here. Then it changes. back in. Notes, because it's all about the power of the groove, you know. Go fucking hard on it, like don't hold nothing back, just go for it, go for the fucking you see, like my whole half of my body is moving, bumping like that shit. It's that's how the effect, that's the full effect of the riff. You just feel the power of the groove, power of the metal, and fucking run with it. Let's continue here, halfway through. Two guitars, that's perfect, and that's how it was originally written in Soulfly, is with two guitars. So, and I'm using a voice box on that one too. I normally don't have one live, so live I just go, I do my part down here and Rizzo does his up here, so my part is just parties. Yeah, sounds fucking sick, chugging. I just like going down here because that's how I normally wrote it with the talk box. So I go down. So it's on this string, on the fifth string, and the fourth string. And you do them together. It's an octave. Octavius. It's an octave from the Roman Empire Legion. Denomination. From the Roman Empire, Octavian probably was the first one to use the octave. Anyway, so it's like this. that reason. And then right now there's some in non-invented lyrics. The deal is when I'm writing, when I don't have the lyrics, a lot of times I do what I call in English that doesn't exist. And it's just a little bit of, yeah, they don't have words. It's a little bit what I do on primitive. Back to back to back to back, primitive. Back to back to back to back, primitive. Back to back to back. You know, it's like the, it doesn't have or a ritual. So it's I do a little bit of this sketch kind of fucking thing on this song too, the part coming up. But let's do the heavy part one more time. Sounds heavy. I love the bass too. Officially programmed, so it was really sick. Roy just kept the beat going hard, and we just threw a bunch of feedback. Lucio doing some sick feedback. I love Lucio do Brasil, Lucio Maia, Nação Zumbi, e da galera do Brasil aí, ó. Bandeira traz tudo aí pra vocês hoje, hein? Porra! Representando o Brasil aqui em Phoenix, Arizona. Valeu, galera do Brasil, assistindo Max Tracks. Puta abraço pra vocês, nunca esqueço de vocês. And so yeah, did some cool fucking feedback, and then some stories. Let me take a water break real quick. There's some cool stories about the recording. We did this record in Malibu at Indigo Ranch, and then I remember that talking to the owner Richard. He passed away, rest in peace, Richard. But he told me that like 200 years ago, Indigo land used to be Indian land. So they used to have like tribal people that lived there, you know. And I was very, very curious about this idea. And I asked him more about it. And he said, yeah, there's probably some Indians buried even in this land, you know. And I was like, wow, that's cool. So they came up with the idea of burying the original tapes. Back then we still recording on tapes, analog. The whole Soulfly one is done in analog. So Chino was there with us from the Deftones, and he remembered this. You guys can ask him when you see him. So we have a bunch of shovels, so we went out in the backyard in front of the studio, kind of like overlooking the hill. We dig this real big holes in the ground, wrapped all the tapes in plastic, so they don't get fucked up, of course. And then we buried them. We left them there for 24 hours to capture the magic power of the tribal land of Indigo Ranch. And I think some of the magic of this record is because we buried the fucking tapes. You know? Mysticism. Gotta keep the mystics alive. I believe in all that crazy shit. And because we buried that and then, you know, left it there for 24 hours, the earth did its thing, the spirits did their thing. We unburied them the next day, covering mud and stuff. We sent it to Andy Wallace to mix in New York. And I heard that he'd received them all dirty, and they called Gloria and asked her. And then she told, yeah, they buried the tapes. That's why they're all dirty and full of mud. And anyway, Soulfly One went gold in America before anything I did with Sepultura and any other project. So Soulfly, very proud of Soulfly, man. You know, that's fucking sick. That's my first gold record in America. Back in the day when you motherfuckers used to buy records, those days are fucking gone, you know? But anyway, it's there in the wall. Gloria can give a little look at it. I think it's the one. Yeah, that's the one right there. That other one is from Australia. And so yeah, very proud. I think it. There's our grandson Rocky. He's hanging out today, playing some video games, talking shit. And our dog is over there. Resting out. We also had Ken Dog in the house, and he brought me a new amp that I'm using, new PV Viper, and that's the guitar. So I'm sick today because of that. We got some cool fucking new gear from Extract. Anyway, that was the story of the day. I hope you guys like it. Bury your tapes when you guys do a recording. I think I'm gonna bury the next Soulfly tape. You know, let's do this again. It depends on when we're gonna record it. So let's do a run through. I'll do my max pick and we're out of here. Thank you so much. No hope, no fear. Thank you. Max Speaks. Got a hardcore one. Corrosion of Conformity. Technocracy! Technocracy! Living in fear! Technocracy! Hungry Child crawling. Happily ever after. Happily ever after. Happily ever after. Ah, blood! Ah, blood! Ah, blood! That's, yeah, I almost sing the whole song. Rest in peace, man. There you go. Oh, what a great record. I love it. I love it, man. You know, like we toured with them back with the Cavalera. We did a Cavalera conspiracy tour with COC playing Blind. Reed was in that tour. We hang out a little bit. So rest in peace, Reed, man. We miss you. This is a killer. If you guys don't know the old COC shit, you guys should check it out, man. A lot of the, you know, Mad World and Eye for an Eye, Animosity, fucking great, great shit. It's probably what not I took Eye for an Eye. Might have been what I took Eye for an Eye for. I don't know. My mind works in mysterious ways, but I don't think it is, but it's great. You guys don't have it, put on your collection. Technocracy. Anyway, thank you for watching Max Trax. We'll be back next Saturday with another banger, probably an older song or something. And or yeah, one thing I talked to Gloria about starting to do and play a lot of songs we don't play live. So I Believe might be one of them, or Feel the Hate, Corrosion Creeps, you know, Bleak, Boom, a lot of those, a lot of cool songs like that. So coming at you next Saturday, Max Trax. Thank you for watching. I fucking love you guys. We roll the outro. Max Trax. Stay metal. Your hands on fire. Thank you so much. I love you guys. See you next Saturday. Max fucking Trax.